Italian mayor's crusade against Islam banned prayers and burkinis. This is going to be all over the place, so prepare yourself. In Monfalcone, a coastal town in northern Italy, Mayor Anna Maria Cisint's stringent policies against the Muslim community have sparked widespread controversy and backlash. Since being re-elected in 2022, Cisint has embarked on a crusade to reshape the town's cultural landscape, introducing measures that directly impact its predominantly Bangladeshi Muslim minority population. These policies include the removal of public benches, limitations on the admission of foreign-born children to schools, and a ban on burkinis at the beach. The most contentious move came in November of last year when Cisint prohibited Muslim prayers at the Darus Salaam Muslim Cultural Association, citing violations of urban planning rules. This act, perceived as a direct assault on religious freedom, led to significant unrest within the community. Bou Konate, the cultural association's president, expressed the sentiment of betrayal and hurt, stating, quote, "It was hurtful and a serious insult we never expected." Despite Cisint's rationale that the space was being misused, the broader implications of her action point to a troubling trend of cultural and religious intolerance, sparking a debate on the balance between integration and preservation of local norms. So let me give an overview, because I had to do some digging into this story because I was not going to believe like one narrative over another. And Armin, in the show notes, I also put a link to a video that we might want to show. Okay, so let me unpack everything that I understand. So there is this town in northern Italy called Monfalcone. And in this town, it has slowly been having a dwindling population. And in general, Italy's birth to death ratio is messed up. It is messed up. Their fertility rate is not doing good. Their internal replacement rate is not doing good. It's the Italians going extinct. It's not as bad as Korea or Japan, but it's bad. It's real bad. If you look at the graphs, you're like, this is bad. So in this town, one of their major sources of industry is building ships. They build cruise ships. The problem is, and this is a major source of tourism in boosting and stimulating the economy in Italy, is these cruise ships and the coastal tourism, right? So what has occurred over the past several decades, this is not a new thing, is that there has slowly been a growing immigrant population of mostly Bangladeshi Muslims coming into Monfalcone to be working on building the ships. And nowadays, it has reached a level where 30% of this town's population is Bangladeshi Muslims or foreign-born people, most of them Bangladeshis. And basically, this town is dealing with an identity crisis, because 30% of their population is not ethnically Italian. And so now this is there's so many different critiques that are going on here. Some people say Italy cannot comprehend the fact that it's an immigrant country now. And they can't deal with the fact that they don't have enough ethnic Italians to keep making Italy, Italy. Other people are like, they just want these immigrants to come here and work on the ships and basically disappear and like not be a part of society. Like, just don't be on the streets. Don't have your own culture. Like, just work on the ships and go home. Like, they just don't want us to exist. They just want us to go do the work and then just like disappear from Italian society. Like, that's a critique that they have. And then other people say, okay, part of our problem is that a lot of these men come and they work on the ships. And then they, because of the laws, they are allowed to bring their wives from Bangladesh, and their wives come from Bangladesh and they have children, but specifically the mothers, like, don't learn any Italian. They don't learn any way to integrate into the society. They don't work. A lot of their husbands don't allow them to work. And basically, this town is becoming very uncomfortable with this contention. They are very uncomfortable with how observant a lot of these people are, especially with the face coverings and all the coverings in general. And so they're looking at ways to try to ban face coverings. Say what you will, but this mayor is pretty honest about what her intentions are. She's like, yeah, we should ban face coverings because it's a security risk and also because I believe it's a denigration of women. Like, she just comes out and says it. You know?
Wow.
So, like, say what you okay. want. Like, she just comes out and says it. And okay. So then the real... A lot of people, and you know, this title might be a little bit misleading, saying that she's banning prayers, whatever. This is a little bit of a overestimation, because what basically happened was that there are a very select few cultural centers, Islamic cultural centers in the city. And there was one that had existed in kind of a converted building for a very long time. And basically it got shut down because that cultural center was being used as a place of worship. And the mayor is saying, I shut it down because it is not permitted as a place of worship. It's permitted as a cultural center. So this is a zoning issue. And then the Muslims, on the other hand, they come back and say, we've been fighting, we've had to go to court, we've had to do lawsuits, we've had to do all this stuff to try to build places of worship, and you guys straight up will not let us. Even though we are Italian citizens, we are naturalized Italian citizens, you will not let us build our own place of worship, so we have this place, and now you shut it down. Like, what kind of message is that supposed to send us? On the other hand, this mayor does a lot of weird stuff too. Like, she started pulling out all these like public benches because she like does
it. Why?
I don't know. The public benches is super weird to me. And then another
is it a home? It's a homeless thing, isn't it? It homeless groups are sleeping on them. I think it's a home anti-homeless thing.
I don't know, but the way that it was framed in the reporting I read, that was basically she doesn't like them sitting on benches in parks or something. And
Muslims sitting on benches in parks.
I know that almost seems insane to me, but that's like the way it was reported. Like, that was the implication. And I was like, what? And then the other thing that's an issue that I think is where this woman is going in a bad direction, unless there's some explanation that I cannot understand, is that she put a cap on the number of foreign-born children that can attend like pre-K. So the amount of foreign-born children that can attend pre-K is like limited to below 45%. And I'm like, if you actually want to integrate a population, why would you do that? If you complain that these people are not becoming Italian, why would you do that? Why would you be like, oh no, we have too many foreign people in our preschools? So
yeah, would it? The best way is to go through the education route. Like, I think like removing public benches and not letting them have a place to pray, that is going to actually worsen the situation. You're now creating an us versus them mentality, and they're going to come. This is going to, like, this is a wave that you're not going to be able to stand against. All you're doing is like making sure that the integration process doesn't happen. I think the best way to target a community like this is to target the children within the education system. That is the best weapon you have to maybe come out of the surviving. And you are basically doing the opposite of that. Again, guys, the only way to survive this is to, given that the wave that is coming, is to not to pick a fight. Because if you try to pick a fight, then they're going to become more radicalized. And by the way, given their sheer numbers, at some point they're going to replace you as a mayor. And given the way that they were treated, the pendulum is going to swing very heavily on the other side. And now you're going to be more likely to have an Islamic mayor at some point, given their numbers. I mean, mayors, last time I checked, mayors are voted into their position. And this type of behavior will end up getting you not just a Muslim mayor, but an Islamist mayor at some point, maybe. I don't know what's going to happen. But again, I really think that given that they're already huge in numbers, the only way to deal with this is to try to figure a way, like the France model, to try to integrate, at least if you can't do it with themselves, at least find a way to get their children out of that brainwashing. I mean, make it mandatory for all their children to come to school and then target the children within the school system and try to get them out of that brainwashing bubble. That's the only hope you have. I don't understand. Like, do you think that I'm wrong here? That's the only way out of this.
I know. Well, I mean, in a lot of, it was kind of funny because in the articles that I was reading, like a lot of people were bringing up France as an exact model of what you don't want to do, not in terms of the recent measures, but I mean, in terms of how, yeah, sure, especially because of France's welfare state, they created an us versus them mentality. So a lot of people reporting on this were saying exactly what you were saying, Armin, basically that this approach is going to backfire because are alienating people so much. And one of the things that confused me is that preschool intervention, that seems like such a dumb idea, period. And okay, another thing was that there's a huge issue in Monfalcone with the Burkini. Like there is as I started to research this, I found articles going back years over the Burkini controversy in this town. And basically they wanted to try to ban it. And then the mayor had all these statements basically being like, if you come to Italy, you have to respect our customs. And people are so confused seeing people swimming, covered up, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay. That might well and good be confusing to you, but how are you going to legislate you have to be undressed at the beach? That just confuses me. I cannot see any good rational argument for that. If anything, that is becoming such a stereotype of what the Islamist thinks the West is, that they will make your women get naked.
Yeah, this is going to play into their narrative. Like, I don't know. I mean, this sounds like a good idea for people who are very tired of Islamism, coming all over Europe. It sounds like a good idea what she's doing, but this will make it bigger. This will make all the problems. I mean, also, this is such a great victimhood narrative. This is only going to empower them. This is not going to stand against the wave that is coming. Again, the main hope that you have is to, you know, this is an ideological battle. You cannot legalize your way out of this, okay? Like, you cannot ban things your way out of this. There's no way. The only way is to fight. The way you fight an ideological battle is with a superior ideology. You fight an inferior culture. Again, these are people with inferior culture. It's true, okay? But you can't legislate. Oh, legislate, that's the word I was looking for. You can't legislate your way out of this. You have to provide a better alternative. You have to go and try to steal their children. Again, that sounds the minds of their children. So I shouldn't. That's not what I literally, don't literally steal their children, okay?
Just Armin is not promoting human trafficking. He is not promoting kidnapping or any criminal activity. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Try to liberate their children out of that ideology, okay? Turn their weapons against them. That's the only method, okay? And you do that with welcoming their children into society, okay? This does not sound... you might think you're coming. No, this is not like turning them into the enemy. In fact, the only way you can survive this is to try to welcome their children out of that Islamic, into society, into a liberal society, out of the Islamic bubble that they live in. This will requires you to go on a charm offense. Okay, what I'm saying is not actually as hostile as you think. This, the weapon that you have, no, it is. It is a charm offense, okay? So not only I'm not advocating for you to be against these people, I'm saying your only tool of survival is to go on a charm offense. Okay. And especially with like the younger generation, with the Gen Z, you know, but here's the thing, you know what you need actually, you know what you need? You need the Atheist Republic. You need to like the stream, because the thing I'm preaching is what we're doing on this channel. Okay. That's what I'm preaching. You need more of Atheist Republic. The way to save Europe is for Atheist Republic to grow as a channel, because we have the antidote. So make sure you like and subscribe. That's what I'm saying. Do you like how that?
Good plug. Good plug. Yeah. You saved it. Yeah, and it was really difficult to find kind of balanced news on this. Like the news was either like The Guardian, which The Guardian's bias. And then the only other kind of coverage I could find from this was some weird conservative website that seemed like it was full replacement theory. And so in when I watched that video, I actually could see what some of the issues in that town were, because they weren't like, if you read just The Guardian talking about the measures that this mayor is doing, you're like, oh my God, this is terrible. How could this be warranted? Blah, 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 blah. And then when you see videos of this footage, basically from the, extreme opposite, you're like, okay, you can see that there are issues here. Like one of them was on camera, allegedly a social worker in this town was saying that, her identity was hidden. That a big issue that they're having is that when the girls turn 16, that they get taken back to Bangladesh and then they get married off and then they get brought back with their husbands and they drop out of school. And I'm like, okay, if that's the case, like, so this is a huge issue, right? Where we need,
yes, like, these are the things that you need to fix. Exactly. This is exactly the part that you need to fix. This is what you need to focus on. Okay. This is where you lose them. This is how they get radicalized. And also removing benches so they don't sit on it, that also helps with radicalization. I need to understand
more behind what that is. They're like, oh yeah, like she removed benches from parks, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, do you just not like to see visibly how many Muslim people there are in the park? Like, I'm assuming that's the implication, but who knows about the reporting? So I'm like, okay, if that's the case, then you need to have strict measures against child marriage. You need to have, I don't know what the age of marriage is in Italy, but if it's the case where you're legally allowed by all citizens to get married at 16, 15, but just most people don't, but now it's facilitating child marriage for this community and then they're not integrating more. Okay, that needs to change. You need to have a bright line policy, 18 or whatever your age of majority is, no exceptions for culture, no exceptions for religion, no exceptions for pregnancy, no exceptions for parental permission, no exceptions for emancipation. 18, no exceptions, or age of majority, no exceptions. And then what you can do to help prevent this is you have provisions in the law that criminalize if you have facilitated a marriage to take a child overseas for marriage and then do the marriage there and then come back, that is also a crime. So like, these are the things that need to be done that would actually be more effective, but it's much more difficult. It's much more difficult, but I don't know. I just thought it was go ahead.
No, I just really want to tell people, guys, this Islamic wave, okay, into liberal countries is so big. Okay. It's so big, and if you, like, it just sounds like a lot of people are like, oh, let's just stand in front of the tsunami and just put our hands up, and maybe, like, something will happen, okay? That's not going to do anything. I'm telling you, you have to turn this into an ideological battle. This is our only hope. Like, we have to fight fire with fire. We have to, like, the Cold War wasn't won because of just the military advantage that the West had. The Cold War was won because people saw which ideology is producing better results. And we are not going to win this war until people realize that we have to show why liberalism wins. So during the Cold War, it wasn't just the military might of the West that won. It was people chose capitalism over communism because they saw what capitalism was bringing them relative to what communism is bringing them. Now this is a lot more complicated battle because we're fighting an older, more ancient ideology. Communism was new and it was a baby ideology. Islam is an ancient ideology and it has evolved, you know, through its evolution. It has become a much more powerful meme. It understands, you know, metaphorically, it understands the human psyche, its hopes, its dreams, its fears a lot more, right? But here's the thing, liberalism works as well, but it's a challenge to show people why liberalism is superior to Islamism, to Islam in general. We have to make that case, and that's our only hope, and that's what we're trying to do here. This is our only hope. If you're trying to win this with military, if you're trying to shoot this ideology, you're not going to win. If you're trying to ban this ideology, you're not going to win. The only way for us to survive this is to convince people, is to talk to people. This is the only path. The more you try to give in with the other weapons, if the more you think that this is a tanks and guns problem, or the more you think this is a legal problem, the more you waste your time on that, the more this threat is going to take over. Because this ideology does not understand bullets or borders. It's going to come. This is a battle of the minds. So come to this army. Join this army. Join the army of people who are trying to convince people out of this. And again, this will produce the most results. And, you know, there's a lot of people don't understand this, and we're going to suffer a lot because of it. But yeah, go on.
Oh, no problem. I was actually going to say, if you can read the super chats while I go to the restroom.
Okay. Sounds good. And at some point, I'm going to need that as well. But let's... Did you want me to play the video first? The video that you gave me?
No, I basically went over the most important part of it.
Okay, sounds good. All right, so let me bring my... Nope, not you, myself. I'm going to put myself on the screen. There we go. Okay, so thank you, Sally Explorer, for the £5 super sticker. I appreciate that. So... Let's go to the next one. Gaijin American saying, Singapore is encouraging its people to procreate in the year of the dragon to make more little dragons. Oh, that's very cute. It might be dragons. But here's the thing. A lot of these policies by the government on encouraging people to have more babies has not worked, unfortunately. It doesn't work because the reason why people decide not to have babies, it's too much. It's too foundational within the changes that has happened within the structure of society and the economy and the nature of work, that just incentivizing people with money or encouragement to have more babies is going against such a foundational change in the structure of society that is very little compared to that major shift that has already happened. So a lot of these policies by governments to try to encourage people to have more children, it's not working because the changes are too foundational for that to have an effect. Okay, so Gaijin American saying, speaking of Gen Z, AR should go on the clock app. By the clock app, I'm assuming you mean TikTok. And if you mean TikTok, you could search for, I'm now going to be more active on TikTok myself. So you could search for Armin Navabi on TikTok, and I'm going to be more active on that app starting yesterday. I posted something yesterday there, so go check it out. Thank you so much for the $10 super chat by Blue. Blue is saying, guys, today we got so many super chats. We're like doing very good, I think, and we haven't even been demonetized. So thank you. Blue is saying, they do not think Italy have better values or will never admit it. You will try to educate their children. They will, They will fart? Is that what you meant to say? They will import more? I don't know what that means. They get power by changing things in Italy. It's a power game. Who are you talking about? Who is they? Are you talking about the Muslims? You will try to educate the children. They will import more. Okay. They get power by changing things. Yeah. But again, that's your only weapon. If you try to educate the children, you have to make it mandatory for the children to be educated by the secular curriculum that the government is putting, and also that includes pro-LGBT. I also think that it should be teaching anti Jewish hatred should be fought against in the school system. Children need to be taught about the Holocaust, about the level of anti-Jewish hatred that exists in the world, LGBT stuff, liberalism, you know, the why liberalism works, that has to be taught mandatory in schools. Again, they're bringing children that you have to, they're bringing more children that they all have to go through that filter. Again, that does work. That does work if you actually make it completely take over the education system and every child having to go through that will have a massive effect, even if they bring in more. I mean, there's nothing else you could do. That's the only weapon you have. But that will have a major effect, I guarantee it. Sid, thank you so much for the super chat. Sid is saying, do you consider Russians to be part of the Western civilization? How come they come to hate the West despite being European? They were completely cut off from the West due to Mongol rule. Okay, so I don't call it Western. I don't want to think about it as a Western ideology versus an Eastern ideology or whatever. I don't think I like to call it the Enlightenment values or Enlightenment ideology, because this is not about the West. The liberal values that I'm talking about, it's not a Western thing. You know, you could see the same ideas work everywhere. Calling it Western civilization or Western values or Western ideas make it seem like it's the West owns them. But you could see that countries that develop these, like use these ideas and their economic system, their political system, and their culture is based on it, heavily relies on it. They prosper no matter if they're in the West or in the East. Like if you look at their non-Western countries like South Korea, like Japan, like Taiwan, these are countries that are, you know, based on their structure of society is based on the same ideals, and they have progressed significantly because of it. And another reason why I don't like to call these like Western civilization or Western ideas is because some of the worst ideas are also Western. So I want to differentiate which Western, you know, which ideas we're talking about, even though these ideas were popularized mostly in the Enlightenment era in Western European country. We have other ideas that came out of the West that are really harmful, like Nazism, for example, is also a Western ideology, or communism. Communism is also Western. Communism came out of Germany. Nazism came out of Germany. Seems to me like it's just all German. No, but like, yeah, but these are all Western. So again, don't call it Western civilization, call it liberal values or Enlightenment values. These are, I think that's, and again, now that you refer to it as Enlightenment, you can see that Russia being Europe or not Europe, Russia being like, well, Russia is mostly Asia, but it's being white or it being partly Europe has nothing to do with it. These are independent from the geography. Okay. These are ideas. Ideas don't understand borders. They spread like memes that they are, right? So why they are, Russia is semi, like partly European and it still doesn't have these values is because of exactly what I just said. Because it has, these ideas don't recognize geography or border. The conditions that we need for them to take over are independent from the location that they are in.
Do you know who makes the most amazing, gorgeous, and other adjectives that I can't use here on YouTube? Blasphemous art ever? We do! And for some reason, we are giving it away for free! Download them now using the link in the description before we change our mind.